New York, and Boston.
A great rivalry that dates back to 1926.
When the game starts, it's not too many friends out there.
These cities need each other more than they despise each other. It's never just another game. It's love and hate fueled by one constant. Passion. If opposites truly attract, no bond is stronger than the one shared between rivals. The Rangers and the Bruins, New York and Boston, till death do us part.
Today, they are very much alive and getting together for the 666th time. It should be a devil of a game as we welcome you to ABC Hockey Saturday, presented by Expedia. The original six rivalry renewed, the New York Rangers and the Boston Bruins at sold-out TD Garden. Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. I'm Sean McDonough, high above the ice, down between the benches. Ray Ferraro, delighted to have you with us. The Boston Bruins trying to continue this history-making season. Their win here over Buffalo two nights ago was their ninth in a row. It gave them 101 points for the season in just 61 games. That's the NHL record, fastest to 100 points. And, Ray, when you evaluate their team, really from the very beginning of the season, it's hard to find a weakness.
Well, you can dig if you want. I don't know what it's going to possibly be. They're a team that is deep. They've sustained injury at the start of the year. They've been on this record-setting pace all season long. And they have the fascinating David Pastrnak at the top of their lineup. Just a brilliant player who scores in every different way, makes him impossible to get your hands on. He's got 14 goals on the power play. He scores in tight, in traffic. He scores down the wing, scores off the rush. His consistency season to season is to be admired. He's what you want at the top of your lineup. But everything in Boston runs around the wheel of Patrice Bergeron. From Zdeno Chara to Bergeron, the Bruins have a culture that says, you do your job, here's your role, can you fit into it? Bergeron makes everything work comfortably for everyone else. Oh, and it doesn't hurt if you've got the league's best goaltending tandem in Jeremy Swayman, and in particular, Linus Ullmark. Ullmark's had a brilliant year, 34 wins on the year. Last week in Calgary, he made 54 saves in an overtime win 2 days after scoring a goal to clinch the win in Vancouver. Just an amazing year in Boston that is hit on just every note from game one to where we are today.
And it's been another good season in New York as well for the Rangers, seemingly solidly on their way to the playoffs again with 79 points, sixth most in the NHL. Little bit of a hiccup lately. They've lost 5 out of 7, including Thursday night against Ottawa, spoiling the debut of Patrick Kane.
Yeah, it's been a little bit of a different season for the Rangers, and in particular as they add Kane, another star-quality player. Last year they target-shopped with Andrew Kopp and Frank Vetrano, and then they brought in Tyler Motte to penalty kill. This year it's about the big names, Tarasenko and Kane in particular. Now, do all these talented players fit in one lineup? Can Gerard Gallant, the Rangers head coach, find the right places for the right people at the right time? It's going to be a fascinating run as the Rangers get ready for the playoffs.
Two of the brightest stars in the NHL, Patrick Kane and David Pastrnak. They'll be on display on a dedicated channel, Star Watch, all day long on ESPN+. Here's our star, Steve Levy.
Very kind, Sean. Right back to you and Ray and Emily in just a moment.